Good morning, students. In this video, we are going to discuss the chapter 6, that is decimals. Okay. So, what is a decimal? Decimal is a fraction having the denominator like 10, 100, 1000, like this. Okay. So, denominator should be 10 or multiple of 10, or you can say the power of 10. So, let us see what do you mean by 1 by 10. 1 by 10 represents the 10th part. Means 1/10. You can write 1 by 10 as 1/10 also, you can read it, and it can be represented in decimal 0.1. How it is? Because you see here in 10, 1 0 is there, so after decimal 1 place is there. So see, 1 by 10 you can represent, how you can represent in the number line. So in a number line, suppose 1 by 10 means 10 divisions are there. So in number line 0 to see 10, 10 divisions are there. So how it is 1 by 10 represent? First you divide the number line into 10 parts. Then first with the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So first part is 0 by 10 and the last part is 10 by 10. So 10 by 10 can be represented as 1, or simply you can write 1.0, and 9 by 10 as 0.9, 10 by 10, 8 by 10 as 0.8, then 0.7 as 7 by 10, then 0.6 as 6 by 10, then 5 by 10 as 0.5, 4 by 10 as 0.4, 3 by 10 as 0.3, 2 by 10 as 0.2, so 1 by 10 as 0.1, and 0 by 10 as 0, simply 0.00. So here we see that the 1 by 10 can be represented in the number line like this. So this is the 1 by 10, means 1/10th part. Total is 10th part, so 1/10th part is there, that is represented by 1/10th. So now look at here, what is 100? 100 means 100 part, suppose 1 by 100, it is the 100 part. If I write here 800, means 8 by 100 800, so the 100 total 100 part is there, but out of 100 80 is there, so that is the 100 part. Then 1000 can be represented as 1000, so you can write like this. How? Suppose 8000 means 8000 means how much? 8 upon 1000. So 8 upon 1000 can be represented in decimal place. How it can represent? So that is 0.00. How many 0 are there? 3 0 are there. So after decimal, 3 places should be there. So 008. And 8 by 100, how we represent in decimal? So that will be 0.08. Because here in 100, 2 0 are there. So after decimal, 2 places. So it can be like 0.08. So similarly, you can represent more the power of 10, like 100,000. So after that also numbers are there. So these are the some of the concepts used in the decimal chapter. A decimal number is represented by two parts. So what are the two parts? Suppose a number is 25.06. So here the 25 represents the whole part. Okay. This is the whole part and this is the decimal, and 06 represents the decimal part. Okay. So how it is? So how we can read the decimal numbers? Suppose the number is 156.0036. We can read like this, 156.0036, or we can represent this number how it is. 156 is the whole part. 156 whole, 36 by 10,000. We can read like this, 156 and 156 and 36,000. Okay. So here you see after decimal 1, 2, 3, 4 places are there. So in 1, how many 0 are there? 4 0 are there, and 36 is the numerical part here, 36. So 36 upon 10,000 and 156 is the whole part, and this is the decimal part. So like this you can read more examples. Suppose I am reading here, writing here 350.23. So here how we can read 350.23? We can read point, not 23, we can read 23. Or we can read, how we can read it, 350.23. So we can represent in decimal, in fraction, 350 whole part and 23 by 100 is the decimal part. Okay. Now look at here, what is expanded form of decimal? Expanded form. So here are two examples I am showing here. First example, 33,000. 33,000, so you can write like this. 33 upon 1000 means 1000. So in decimal, how you can write? 33. So here after decimal should be how many places? 3 places. But here 3 places, 2 places are there. So you can write 0.033. So it is represent the 33,000. Okay. Now look at this example. 28 and here and is given. So 28 and, so 28 is the whole part. 28 is the whole part here. And 17, 10,000. So 17 right here on the numerator and 10,000 in the denominator. 10,000. So here, so 28 and 17,000 can be represented in this form of the fraction. So in the mixed fraction, so 28 is the whole part. So 28 writing in the middle, 28 and 17 is the numerator. 17, 10,000. 10,000 is the denominator. How we represent in the decimal part? So 28.17. How much? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 places. But here numerator 2 places are there. So put another 2 0, 0 0 1 7. So here now it will be after decimal 4 places. So 28.007 is represented by this word number. In number words, it represents how it is 28 and 17 10,000. But in numerical part or decimal part, it is 28.0017. Okay. Now look at here, what is standard form? Standard form of decimal. So a number is given in the expanded form already given. In the expanded form already given here. So here current form, how this is represented? Already standard expanded form is given here. We can make it to decimal form. Standard. So 423. So look at here this part. This part is the whole part here. So 423 plus. So 4 upon 10. That means 0.4 plus. Here 0 upon 100 is there, that means 0, then 3 upon 1000, that is 0.003, because see here 3 0 are there. So if 3 0 are there means after decimal 3 places, here it is 1 place is there, so 0.003 equal to, so how write 423 decimal. So if you add this decimal, it will be how much? 0.403, because in the middle part 0 is there, so 403. So 423.403 represent the standard form of this decimal. Okay, this is the expanded form, after expanded form to standard form, that is 423.403. Okay, now just look at here the expanded form of this 33,000. So we are representing decimal 0.033. So here the first 0 represents 0 by 10 and the second 3 is 3 by 100 plus this third one is 3 by 1000. So this is the 1000 place. Now next example, 28.0017. So 28 is the whole part plus first is 0 by 10 because of 10th part and second one is 100 part. So 0 upon 100 plus the third one is 1 upon 1000. Fourth one is 7 upon 10,000 because it's the 10,000 part. So this is the expanded form of this decimal number. Okay.